Last week's portion and this week's portion, Korach, really, I think, highlight for us what the Torah is really about. Though we may imagine that the Torah's purpose is to motivate us to be better people and to focus on the Ten Commandments and such beautiful laws and principles such as love your neighbor as you would want to be loved, the Torah really is about human nature and the tragedy that how easy it is for us to fall back to ways in which we are sinful or at least neglectful in our conduct. And so the portion Shlach Lecha, as the spies reported back on their 40-day mission to Israel, and the people immediately pounced on the negativity of their speech. And this week's portion, in which Korach, Moses' cousin, leads a band of people in rebellion against Moses and Aaron's leadership, these two portions highlight for us the failings of human nature and the idea of how much we as human beings need to overcome our nature in order to be better people. These two portions really serve as the crux of what it means to be a human being and how difficult and challenging it is for us to really be people that reflect social justice and love. That is what God wants us to be. The rabbis understand that the middle of the Torah portion, highlighting what the most important value is, that is, ve'ahavta l'reyecha kamocha, love your neighbor as you would want to be loved, that is overwhelmed by our human weakness and human failings. And so the rest of the Bible itself is also a reflection of the idea of how the people missed out on their calling to be better people and what life would have been like if only the people could have been swayed by their good conscience as opposed to their evil conscience. And so that, I think, is the message of Shlach Lecha and Korach. Here we are as failed people. What are we going to do? What were they going to do? What are we going to do today to overcome our failings and weaknesses and to be the better people that we know we can be? Shabbat Shalom.